never witnessed on a rugby field.
It's Arkwright to Ellery Hanley. He's got Joe Lydon on his outside, he's going himself. Oh, this is the chance. Ellery Hanley's going all the way. Inside to Lydon, and he's got it. A magnificent try.
To Burton, first touch of the ball. Another forward who broke a leg at the end of last season, but now thankfully recovered. Pinner, oh, lovely dummy from Pinner. He's split them all wide, he's got Hanley with him. Scorpion, he's going in for his fourth try. Yes! Switching play nicely, Tony Myler. Looking for Burke, coming down the middle, he gets it there. Oh, excellent rugby. This could be a copybook try, David Hume. The full length of the field, Richard Francis is chasing him. Oh, and he misses him. Oh, good ball for Tony Myler, lightens away again. Looking to pass, he gets it away to Hume again. Oh, superb rugby. And just look at that.
Very, very scrappy there. Yeah. I think Halifax have had a very hard season, look very, very tired. So at all, they're not giving them really.
But a very difficult kick by Robin Whitfield. Normally, I think most sides would have put the ball into touch and played through the six tackles. But I think the sides are expecting the half-time hooter any second now. The 40 minutes are up, so it's well worth an attempt at 2 points. No. In there is John Cross. It's surprising how hard this pitch has suddenly gone this week in this spring-like weather. Have a lot to do. They've got to move this ball about. They're concentrating far too much, I think, down the middle of the field. Devotee. It's strange to see a whole side, Alec, not moving the ball about with a star-studded set of backs like they have.
Yes, it is, and it's just one-man football, one-man drive and one-man support, and the very little idea that they're just running with the ball and hoping that somebody will make a break.
Well, here's one man who is running with the ball. He's made a good break, and he's got Brand with him. But a good tackle from Whitfield. And all credit there to this youngster McBrand. He came in well, he's a big lad, he wants some stopping, and he almost caught this Halifax side napping. To Stevens, this is the man that Hull have got to pick up, Gary Stevens, number 7. He's been doing all the damage in that first half, laying the ball off for the forward, making those little grubber kicks. Stevens again. Crossley. Oh, that's a good dummy by Crossley. He's got the speed, this lad, but Campbell's there. Just doesn't get the ball away. And the referee got in the way there. Ronnie Campbell can't do anything about it. And nice to see Mick Scott there. Yes, number 8. He realises it was an accident. Good rugby league spirit there from Mick Scott, laughing his head off, even though it might have cost his side a try. Let's get on with the game, says Ronnie. To Hull. Arcoy. What a knockback. No, it's not. Stevens. Chris Anderson. All well taken by Scott Wilson. James had a good season, this Neil James, in his first Great Britain cap this season against France. Stevens again to Julie. Oh, that's a good strong run. Steve Smith to take the goal, the substitute for Colin Whitfield, but Smith himself, and this was why he was placed on the substitute's bench, a good goal kicker himself, but not this time. So Halifax then going out still further now, 26 points to 10. Stevens again. Well, he's still got the ball out, and just look who's there supporting this hooker again, McCallion. Neil James. And McCallion again. What a fine game this lad's having here.
He's a very, very good player. He works and works and works. He's a busy little bee, and he fits into this kind of play.
Anderson, all well picked up by Anderson, and he's going over. He's there. Excellent backing up, and didn't he look pleased with himself, Chris Anderson? He's had a marvellous season as player coach for his Halifax side, and I'm sure now his thoughts must be on the double. He must be looking to get towards that Premiership Trophy final now. All these Halifax players now just can't get enough of this ball. And this man Anderson certainly setting the example. Good backing up. This should be the easiest of kicks for Smith. He's missed two so far since he came on as substitute for Whitfield, but they were very difficult ones. But I don't think you have too many problems with this. And he doesn't. So six more points, 32 points to 10 now for Halifax. And many of us were saying, Alec, before the game, well, they might be a little bit too tired to take this game.
Yes, but once you win a cup there, you realise that you've won that cup for playing 9 months of the season, and Halifax don't want to lose it this time of the season. I think they can win the other one. And this is what it was all about this time. Neil James, a big, strong lad, and once he gets into a stride, this fella, he takes some stopping. With beautiful support and well trained by Chris Anderson, good captain and led like a captain and finished like a captain.
Just look at that number 8 there, Lee Crooks, how he managed to get out of the scrum to take the scrum half, I'll never know. Wilson. Not to Arnett. Devorty. Ball to Gascoigne, and a good ball. Yes, good pass. Excellent try to Billy Mallinson, the hooker. Good backing up. We've seen some very, very good support play from these two hookers, McCallion and Mallinson. But I also like the work of the scrum half, Andy Gascoigne, in that try. Hole going to the end. And it should be a comfortable kick here for Gary Schofield. But I don't think this Halifax side will be too bothered about that. Just 8 minutes to go, and really I think it's going to take a Herculean effort from this whole side to catch them up.
Well, the first time we've seen no really move the ball about here, and again it's Fred Akoi, a lovely ball from Mirko Anderson. Akoi draws the man in, Gascoigne in support. Lovely ball, slips it out, Gascoigne there, there he goes, he draws a man here, and Mallinson any moment now in support for the simplest of try, and very badly needed throw.
Two minutes to go. Players here, I think, going through the motions. I think this whole side now will be glad to see the back end of the season. Not a very good season by Hull standards, but such are the traditions at this club. I'm sure we'll see them bounce back next season. And for Halifax, what a season they've had. The Rugby League champions, first time in 20 years, really the third time in their history, and now on their way to the semi-final of the Slalom Lager Premiership Trophy. And that little lad Gascoigne, he can still laugh about it, Alec, can't he?
Yes, well, he's a scum match. You've got to have a sense of humour in this game, and I think he's got a great sense of humour. He's also got the ball.
It's a kick to touch, but I think it'll only be academic. The crowd invading, but again, under the law, referee Campbell must play out the next tackle. Groups driving in. Seconds to go. Devote. To Schofield. Oh, good bunny from Schofield. He's got O'Hara with him. That's a nice try. Yes. Good try. And I think that second try there from O'Hara really shows what might have been by this whole side. If only they'd use these wings a little bit more. The gaps are there. The space is there. Good centre play from Schofield. And good finishing from O'Hara. Minutes gone, we're into injury time now, so the kick purely academic. It will help Gary Schofield's goal kicking record this season, but it doesn't.
Well, this is Hull, you know, the first time it's in the show, we're to this game running the ball out. Gary Schofield opens his leg for the first game of the season, stretches his leg, it's a lovely long ball to Danawara, takes it well, and goes into the corner.
So there's the man of the moment there, Chris Anderson, the Halifax player coach. And I think with this 32-20 win, he must be thinking, well, can my side do the double now? They're into the semi-final, and who knows?
Good start.